Let's take a second to look at all the different settings in AirSync so you understand what they mean. So with the AirSync app open, I'm gonna find the settings gear icon in the bottom left. I'm gonna select that, and the initial settings are what we call the device settings. So one of the more important settings is what's called the device name. This easily lets me identify what the device is called, especially when I have multiple of them in different rooms. So you can rename that there. Keep in mind, you can have no spaces in that. You can choose your language. You can do what's called show display code on top. So when we're using the AirSync app, you'll notice there's the display code here, and then we have our one-time password. If I'm on the home screen, for example, I can come into the settings and say show the display code on top. When that's enabled, you'll see up here, the AirSync icon will display over everything else. And so if I tap that, it will quickly show me the name as well as that display code and the one-time passcode information. So if you want that enabled, just go into your settings and turn that show display code on top. This notification here that says, if invited to a display group, notify me. We're not gonna talk about how to do a display group in this video, but be sure to check out our other video. Essentially, you can link multiple ViewSonic displays together. This setting here just says, hey, if my display is trying to get grouped into another group, notify me so I can approve that. You'll also see that there's this option to autofill the one-time password. That means after you successfully connect to a device, it essentially can remember that device, so it'll autofill the passcode so you don't have to constantly be typing it in over and over, but you can also disable that feature. Lastly, we have this setting down here that says allow screen sharing only with approval requests. What this means is that if I'm trying to cast something like my iPad and I want to display to this device, we'll get the display code here. You'll see here when I click share, see this approval that pops up where I have to accept or decline the cast. If you don't want to have to do that, you can go to the settings and you can just uncheck that, and then it will automatically cast without that approval popping up. So that's the device settings. Next, you'll see you have the broadcast menu. This does two different things. One, it allows you to broadcast out to your devices. So one of the things we're going to talk about in one of our other videos is how to receive the screen. In order to receive the screen to your device, like if I wanted to receive the view board to my iPad, I would need to have this toggle turned on. That's the only way that I can receive the screen. And then down here, you're gonna see you have this boards option. This is what we call like a display group. So if I wanna link multiple view boards together, this is where I could do that. So I can essentially come in here, I can choose my display group and click save, and then it will start broadcasting. We'll show you how to do that in another video as well, but that's where that setting is. Below that, you're gonna see your mirroring option. So in addition to using the AirSync app, you can also use AirPlay, Chromecast, Miracast. All these services are defaults turned on. If you wanted to disable any of them, you can. You'll also notice that there's the option to require a passcode when utilizing AirPlay. And then of course you can enable or disable the auto accept or the auto add when you're using these different services for casting. Your connectivity option is essentially if you're using just your network to cast or if you're gonna allow for web-based casting. So let me explain a little bit. A lot of times if I have a teacher device like this iPad, if this device is on the same network as the ViewSonic display, we call that a local connection. So if that was enabled here, essentially I can only cast from devices that are also on the same network as the board. But what about maybe a student device? Or what if you had another device from someone who's not on your network? You would want to enable both internet and local connection because that person could then use their web browser essentially to cast to the screen or board. So by default, both of these are turned on. However, if you wanted to limit the board to either just your local connection or internet, you can change that here. Finally, you have what's new, and then you have the legal and extra information there. And then if you X out of it, that'll close your settings. So everything you want to be able to do to the AirSync app is just down in that settings cogwheel. Remember, it's most of your casting, your network features, and of course you can rename the device if you would like to.